Hey guys, it's Broker Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool career mode, where last time I left off, I picked up wins against Spurs and Manchester United. Now in this episode, I will be giving you three matches in this episode, because the next time you'll be watching this career mode will be Saturday, and when you do, you'll be watching me on my birthday. Yes, next he is my birthday, and a special treat, you're getting a double dose of Manchester clubs. So in this episode, I'm giving you three matches. Is this game against West Ham, the Champions League game against CSKA Moscow. If I win that, I will qualify for the next round automatically. He rendered the last two games pointless. And of course, the huge game against Chelsea. But first, let's play the Hammers. It's at Anfield in the rain.
Today, as we welcome you to the home of Liverpool Football Club, comes from Anfield, and we're looking forward, Alan Smith and myself, Martin Tyler, to
Henderson, Bale. Get off to a nice early start. To Royce.
Gareth Bale starts with Marco Royce in the wide positions.
So a couple of strikers for them at the front end of the team.
West Ham United's lineup is this.
Porte.
Bale.
Pass didn't come off.
And a partnership with these two strikers up front.
Lanzini.
Top defending this season.
Valencia and Klein gets rid of it. Cresswell with the throw. He gives it to Valencia. Valencia and Lanzini do 1-2. Now it's come to Sacco. Oh, and I do very well to get rid of that. I know what I got time for. Now that. Oh, was that going? Oh, wow. The referee didn't see anything wrong with that. I thought he might give a foul. Oh, but no. What? Yes! Oh, it's actually Jordan Henderson. With all the goals he scored last season, that's his first in this season. And it only took him 11 matches. At this point, he had already had about 3 or 4. But the captain is off the mark. And we are 1-0 up. Very good goal. Didn't give Adrian much chance, did he? Winston, he tried to stop it. But he was just too slow for the challenge. It probably would have been a penalty. Anyway, if he had. Fouled Henderson. In any event, it's 1-0. Now they have to equalise, and they're going to look to do that straight away, but I'm going to look to make it 2-0. Bell. Sturridge, come on. Get a good cross in. Oh, Adrian met that first. Henderson! Oh, for God's sake. Valencia.
Nathaniel Klein.
Get the ball back. Here's Klein. Coutinho. Bale. Yo. Make a run. Yes. Sturridge. Oh, he gets the ball off me. He was trying for the pass, but it didn't come out. Royce. Come on. Brian, you lucky son of a... Rodriguez. Correa. Corner. I'll take the corner. Varane. Oh, Varane scores his second goal of the season. This one is definitely his. There's no question about that. And after his center back. But he Laporte scored in the game against Spurs in the last episode. Varane decides to get in on the action himself. Took a deflection off Cresswell's shoulder. But it's in, and it's definitely Varane's second goal of the season. His third goal in a Liverpool shirt. What? How is that not a foul? Not sure how that wasn't a foul. His oh, that was a really bad pass from Noble. Excuse me. Henderson. Sturridge. Tompkins gets in the way. It's Klein. Ah, the pass. Smart dicks. They got in the way. Henderson. Come on, Jordan. A lovely cross here. Or could it end up being good? Ah. Keep it West Ham with her. Really good defending.
Real good contest between these two as they jostle for possession. Lanzini.
Oh, that was almost No. Ooh. That was almost my second goal of the season. See it? Oh yes, my keeper. What an amazing save. Yo, get that out of here. Oh, thank Christ, it is half time. Yo, West Ham and came back into the picture. Whew. That was too close for comfort.
And the referee has blown, and the second half is now in progress.
Could have easily been 2-1. Probably should have been 2-1 if not for my keeper making it. Amazing save.
Valencia. Lanzini. Now he's got the ball back. He's one possession.
Royce. Henderson. Sends it over. Looking for Bale. Can he get there? He's easily going to get there. Sturridge, no. Correa, back to Bale. Oops, it again. It's out again. Sacco, Valencia. Huh. I'll take the yellow card. I'll take it. I couldn't risk them hitting me on the counter attack. And now they've made a substitution. Wait, who came on? Oh, it was Andy, wasn't it? Was it Andy? It's not even going to tell me? Oh, Gordon. Who the hell's Gordon? Coutinho. Looking for Sturridge. Sturridge, boom. Sturridge, we exit 3-0. Oh, and whoo! That is a weight off of the shoulders.
One team really on their game today, the other very off colour.
I still don't want West Ham to score, but if they did, it'll still be two behind. Or they might be... He fall behind. Coutinho. Oh, just after Sturridge leveled with Coutinho. Coutinho's like, no, I'll take that and score, thank you very much. And it's 4-0 for the second Premier League game in a row. Oh, and being a London team, 4-0. The London clubs have been taking a smashing from he as a late. I'm not very happy here with me right now. Although it's the London club I play in the next league game that I really want to beat. It's all fun and games till you beat the team in second place, who I'm already 9 points ahead of. Jose Mourinho will not be very happy if the gap becomes 12.
Just to check on the weather for you. Was never in doubt the game, but certainly the players will be pleased that some of the puddles that looked as though they might be appearing have disappeared.
Yeah, more of a drizzle, I think, after the downpour. But it will have quickened up the pace of the ball across the surface when the rain really fell.
Uh-oh. Lanzini. Yes, for rain. Bale. Since Sturridge true. Ooh.
Well, the ball deserved perhaps a better response from his teammates in the middle.
Probably should have went on and shot for myself, but not to go on the safe route and cross it in. Henderson! Oh, he was looking for a second of the game. Correa! Correa tried something fancy and he didn't really pay off. Uh-oh, here comes Payet. Not sure why he wouldn't be starting. Especially against the team in top of the table. Oh, not sure why you're bringing him on when you're 4-0 down. Penalty! Oh, imagine. I'm not sure why Adrian punched it. There's a lot of confusing things just happened. Like, why did they give that to Correa? And he buries it. Oh, what a dopey mistake from, I think it was Tompkins. Yeah, it was. Poor control. Well, and Correa steals it away from him and puts it past Stajan without any real issue. 5-0. West Ham, we're going home very unhappy and with no points whatsoever. Coutinho got 9.8. Attaboy, Philippe. Attaboy. Attaboy? Attaman. That doesn't sound right, does it? The saying is attaboy. Although that sounds weird. In any event, let's see, who do I got? Who am I putting on this training session? I'm putting you. Russian killer. My scout found. See if I can't get Lawrence up. I'm trying to get him to a point where our clubs will actually come in and loan him. I'm going to look at doing all of my young players. Someone here as well, isn't there? Yeah. Guy. Gontarov. Probably said that completely fucking wrong. But, there you go. There we go. Expect at least the first and the fourth fella to go up. They are. Lawrence and the last guy might go up as well. Miranda's probably the only one who shouldn't really go up. They're all pretty close though. Oh, well, the last fella didn't go up. man almost went up too. Freaking hell, good work. I was right, Miranda did not go up. What a dick. Oh wow, Spurs lost to Sunderland. Hell yeah, well done Sunderland. Although Spurs are on the table a bit, so they're not really going to be a team I should be worrying about in this year's Premier League. Oh wow, Chelsea dropped more points. Chelsea dropped points again. Chelsea and City both dropped points again. Yo. I don't even need to play City and Chelsea. They're bringing themselves for me. Seriously. United are in 7th. Arsenal are in 5th. And Chelsea and City are dropping points even before I play them. Yo, this is probably going to be the easiest season yet. Yeah, at the rate they're going. Before I've even played them, the gap is 11 freaking points. 11 points. It's not really a good gap. A5, nope, not good enough. A3, sorry Miranda, goodbye. A6, nope, it's not good enough either. These three are all good. In any event. Now, time for another Champions League game. I'm going to Russia to play CSKA Moscow. I think I'll actually win the group if I win this match. I'm not sure though. Just check that at the end of the game. I'm gonna play some of my lesser used players. Here's Otazel. I'm gonna play. I'm gonna start Chan. I'll probably bring on Donza later in the game. Yeah. So this is going to be the team that plays against the Russians. Well, the Russian side anyway. I don't know if they have any Russian players. Probably half their team are Russian.
Teams now facing their fourth match in this Champions Cup group stage.
All I need to do is win. Let's see what match day four brings. Knockout stage of the Champions League. My destination.
Here's the team for CSKA Moscow. Igor Akinfeyev plays in goal. Roman Yaremenko starts. He was man of the match in his last game. And they'll play with a sole striker. This is the Liverpool side.
What's that? Divock Origi! Boom! Bottom corner. Buries it. Hit no problem. And it's 1-0. I'm not wasting any time. I'll fine now! Took 6 minutes to score that first goal. Mano! Ooh! High on confidence I am.
The manager here has had an attractive offer to
Chan.
International level, but
Moreno.
Attractive enough for him, it
seems. Ibe.
No, it seems not.
Ings.
Surprise, but, perhaps it's the extra work.
John Ibe! Ooh! I'm probably scaring the shit out of that keeper. Danny Ings! Oof. Not sure why I keep shooting long ranges. Let's try short range. Hey, Ibe. Tell me that's not a goal kick. Ah! Of course it is. Zell. Origi. What's Zell? 2-0. I know his name is not Otazel. I just can't pronounce how it is. So so I took Ozil's name and I put a spin on it because he has similar letters than Ozil, doesn't he? Oh wow. How did he lose that ball over there? Free kick. What? How's that not a free kick? Come on, ref. Just because I'm 2-0 up doesn't mean you can't give me free kicks. When an obvious foul happens, I would have been super pissed off if he didn't win a free kick. Oh, come on, Origi. He put more power into it. I don't know why I'm telling him to put more power into it. That was my fault. Note, shoot with more power. Her power shots are hard to save. Oof. Keeper easily caught that. Another counter attack has begun. What the hell? Running like a gazelle. Penalty! Thank you very much! What a bloody idiot. I don't know what he was expecting. And the yellow card as well. Oh, why not? Chicken of the Vov. Wow. 42. Is Kamala the best man for the job? No, it says Danny Ings is the best man for the job. And he make it 3-0. He's already scored in this match. Boom. Wait, no. Rigi scored the first goal, didn't he? So that is Ings' first goal of the game. I think he had a chance to score. And in the event, it's 3-0. Danny Ings, second goal in the Champions League. Not bad. Well done, Danny. And it's half time. Perfect timing. Not even gonna look at the Celtic Inter game because that result, it's not gonna affect me no matter what happens. Here's Musa and Ilori. He is quick to snuff out the danger. See, this is why I gave him a new contract. Probably saw that in my messages just before this game. Oh, Origi! It's the chance for your second goal of the game. The Moscow fans are like, oh shit! Kamano. Offside. Brilliant. Well, at least he called it early. Not wasted my time by waiting 5 fucking hours to call it. Oh. What a pass to Ibe. Bury it, Jordan. Oh. Sewell. Come on, you can get there. Come on. Ah. Goal kick. Brilliant. Come on now. I don't want to be careful. It looked like he was trying to get up in Kamano's business. Fingertip saved there by the keeper. Jordan Ibe. Oh. Laurie, he scored in the Europa League. He scored in the Champions League. Not many players can say they've scored in both major European competitions. There you go, now you can, Nori. For the second year in a row. He scored in the group stages of the Europa League, and now he's done it in the Champions League. It's the justifying the decision to give him a new contract. It's 4-0. Instantly, Kamano! Oh, wow! I'm not sure what happened there. Probably put too much power on it. After complaining in the first half, I didn't put enough power on my shot. But there, I put too much. It's just the way, isn't it? Oh, what a Zell's header is saved by the keeper. Alright, and it's another corner. Chan. Come on! Ooh! Wernbloom. It was in the right place at the right time for them. Ibe! Ooh! Yo, Claire, dude.
4-0 here, and almost time up. What does this mean for their next game?
Well, Liverpool go up against Chelsea. And they've certainly done the job out here, and they'll be confident of doing it again in the next one.
There goes the cross.
Yo, that one was went in without Ibe. He making a nuisance of himself. Oh, he was 5 miles offside. It wouldn't have counted anyway. Oh, the defender's made a mistake. He's giving it straight to Kamano. Oh, one of his fellow defenders made up for his clumsy mistake. Almost the same. Well, not almost the same thing as what your man did. What Tompkins did. Tompkins just had a miscontrolled it. Ibe! Ooh! This is why I said in the first time. I might play Moskov that Akinfeev is a good goalkeeper. He's really good saving shots. I mean, yes, I've beaten him 4 times in this match. But that doesn't mean the fact that he is still a really good keeper. And there we go. Qualification for the next round. Secure. Easy as you like. Easy as you bloody like. What? Thiago and Laurie. He got an 8.5. Which was my highest rating. Inter beat Celtic 1-0. Like I said, I don't really know what that means for the table. I don't really care. But I'm sure there's a lot of you who probably do want to know what that means. So I will check. Because all you will probably want to see. That means Inter are now in the had automatic qualification in spot. But I have won the group. Because there's only two games left. And Inter and Moscow are both 8 points behind me. So I can sim the last two games, lose both, and still finish top of the group. That's brilliant. Oh, this one. Let's look through the other groups. Pretty tight there. There's no one in guaranteed progression yet. It's really tight there as well. There's literally a point between first and second, second and third, and third and fourth. United have qualified, and Juventus are just not there yet. They'll probably qualify in the next set of games. So United are definitely through. Juventus will follow suit. Very close there between Arsenal, Bayer Leverkusen and PSG. PSG top on 8 points. Arsenal and Leverkusen both have 7. Chelsea are safe. Porto not there yet. They need to win their next game to secure progression. Ahead of Spartak Moscow. Although Spartak Moscow have only won game, so wouldn't be too big a shock if they. It'd be a bit of a shock if they did catch them. Ajax are topping a group at Real Madrid. Huh? Right. Okay. If you say so. Ajax have. They've not qualified yet. They need a point from their next game to secure qualification. Real Madrid aren't secure either. They need to win their next game. Barcelona not secure yet. Anderlecht could still catch them. In theory. But if you look at the goal difference, you're like, yeah, not really. It's much closer between Zenit, Anderlecht, and even Besiktas could still catch Zenit, especially with two games left. And we're back to us. All the fun times happening in the Champions League. Let's go destroy Chelsea and extend the lead from 11 to 14 points. Yeah, that's about to happen. Although, chances are, when I beat Chelsea, City will go second. So, there you go. I don't know who City are playing. It's only a 2-goal difference. So. Whoops, what am I doing? City are not playing at the same time as me. Well, I'll keep an eye on the Arsenal scoreline. They are somewhat still in the race. Right? Oh, wow, Bale's up to 90. He's like, screw being in the 80s. I'm 90. Well, Mr. Bale. Oh, la-dee-da. He ain't wasting anybody. He ain't wasting He is not wasting time in growing. Oh well. Now I remember when I played this fixture about this time last season, I drew it. So I'm going to go for the kill straight away. Yeah, I'm not going to waste any time, literally, from the kickoff. Chelsea are playing around the back. That's always a danger. You have to go for eventually. Your draw is not going to close the gap. Oh, and Matt Hitch. He didn't want to see what was going to happen there. Smart man. Correa! It was after the 0-0 draw that I got pissed off at Correa, so this is definitely a game where he'd want to prove himself. Varane almost scored again. With his second goal in consecutive league games for the centre back. Uh oh. No, you don't, Pedro. Oh, I know what you were thinking. He was thinking in counter-attack. But I'm thinking, Bell, boom, goal, 1-0. Oh, can someone say 14 points? Ironically, it was in the 14th minute. In terms of shots, there's a real gap between these two sides, reflected in the... Yo, Bell, instead of a heart, hold up a triangle. Oh, then all the conspiracy! Oof. Oh, Nathan, he was offside. It would not have mattered. His goal would not have counted if he had scored. No, my keeper had the ball clearly. Rodriguez looks for Sturridge again. It's his former club. Oh, what a beautiful control from Daniel Sturridge. He just couldn't put it past Courtois. This is... Shots on hit. One of the main reasons Chelsea are struggling is because they don't have that immense, huge Belgian wall in goal right now. They have to sell for a really good Bosnian keeper instead, who's not doing as well as he did at Stoke, and is probably making Mourinho say, "What the hell?" Oh, Mourinho talks. I believe that I made a bad decision. Although he would never admit he made a bad decision. That sounds more like Wenger anyway.
Here's a chance to move forward from midfield after that interception. Diego Costa.
Klein. Tried to get through to Sturridge. It's Correa.
And it's come to John Terry. And he tried to get out of the way, the referee.
Way hit the referee.
The crowd love this when the ref gets in the way. At least some of the crowd do.
The goalkeeper can... The keeper's got that easily. Oh, whoa, ball for... Correa. What a ball for Correa. Oh! After an amazing ball from the keeper, straight to Correa. Yo, would have been an assist for the goalkeeper. It's rare he does anything other than get clean sheets, but there you go. He almost got an assist against Chelsea of all teams. Oh, oh boy. Yes, Varane. Oh, get rid of it again, Varane. Yes, good man. Come on, can we get a second goal just before half time? Sturridge. Hid. Whips it in. Looking for Coutinho. Couture got there first. Dick. It's still there. Sturridge. Oh, Couture with an amazing save.
We've got the details coming up now. The corners.
Henderson. Correa. Oh. Oh boy. Ooh. I would have had to have taken a yellow card if the referee didn't blow up for half time. You say my rump. Chelsea were probably going to counter attack there. Henderson. Correa. Ivanovic gets rid of it. Bring it back. Sturridge gets it off Azpilicueta. Nathaniel Klein. Whip it in. Oh, Coutinho couldn't. Oh, that was Correa. Freaking getting confused. They both have curly black hair. Getting confused. He's not paying attention. Yeah, what?
Change for Chelsea here. Diego Costa.
Yeah, not this time, Costa.
Jordan Henderson.
Oh, oh, shoot. Yes, Henderson. And doing his defensive work, but giving it straight back to him. Yes, get rid of it, Royce. Anywhere will do. To Correa is even better than anywhere. Huh? This may end up in the back of the net. Ah! Oh! That's where Quetta. He's all over the place. Bale! Oh, corner. Wait, what? The Chelsea defender. Oh God, they're bringing on Fabregas. Oh, they brought on Hazard. No. I need to kill this now. Oh, before they get it back into this. Coutinho. Yes, 2-0. Oh, Chelsea have been vanquished. 14 points. Suck on that, Mourinho. Cahill was all over the place. The Chelsea defense are not home today. Hey, despite being at home, they're upstairs anyway. And Coutinho slips in and puts home goal number 10. I asked them to kill it off, and that's exactly what they do. Brilliant. I will be going for a third goal. I mean, 2-0 isn't exactly killed off, but it's better than 1-0. Oh, Sturridge! Make it 3! Coutinho again! Ah, oh, 3-0! Coutinho is 11th of the season. He scored again! He doesn't like Chelsea. I'm convinced now. He scored 2 against them in real life, and he scored 2 against them at the bridge once again. Oh, the irony of this. It's 3-0. All we show is this with Chelsea to pull one back and Mourinho to be absolutely silent. because he's a little biatch. 3-0. Oh, 14 points. Here I come. I mean, Chelsea are always a danger before goals. Also, I'd be very disappointed if I conceded 4 goals. Goals to any team. Even if they are second in the table for now. Because, right now. Because, if only, I think Correa was who's been called for offside. Yeah, if only, because Coutinho would have had his hat trick. So that down is the confirmation I'll be playing Manchester City in the next episode. There is a Champions League game which I'm going to sim in between. But next episode is all about being both Manchester clubs. Coutinho for the hat trick! Ooh. He really wants to get the hat trick.
Chelsea needing some divine intervention.
Correa. Free kick. No? Really? Oh. Oh, Pedro. Is he going to pull one back? Oh, he missed. He missed. Oh, that should have been 3-1. I'm not going to lie and say that should have been 3-1. I got extremely fucking lucky there. I'm not gonna lie. Sturridge, Henderson, Correa, Coutinho, free kick. Surely that's a free kick. What? How is that not a free kick? There's the full-time whistle. It doesn't matter. Get on the floor, Fabregas. Continue. Oh, bro. He's... and a Gareth Bale. A controversy goal. Oh, because it was... to confirm 14 points in the 14th minute. 3-0, and I say 14 points. Can City catch me? No. Can Arsenal catch me? No. Can Chelsea catch me? Yeah, that's a no. That's definitely a no. I think it's safe to say I'll be winning the league again. Because there's not even a challenger in sight. I can't see any of them. I got no problems. My competition ain't even in sight, yo. Oh, this is brilliant. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Come back in the next episode, where I'll be playing in FIFA on my birthday. Thanks for watching this last FIFA mode episode. I'm 19. I'll see you all when I'm 20 years old.